So now we have understood how multiplicities affect the polynomial and how we are able to find the multiplicities of the polynomial functions with some factors. Correct. Still, we don't have an answer to a question that what is deciding this behavior, that this function will go to infinity, this function will go up as usual. How this behavior is decided? We don't have any answer for that. Let us try to understand that through what is called end behavior of the polynomials. So the next slide is actually the end behavior of the polynomials. Okay. So let us go to the next slide, which is end behavior of the polynomials. So what is an end behavior of the polynomial? In order to understand end behavior, let us define the end behavior properly based on our understanding of quadratic equations. So when we studied quadratic functions, we looked at the term of the form a2x square plus a1x plus a0, right? And then we talked about a2x square, whether a2 is greater than 0 or a2 is less than 0. Then we decided the behavior of the function. If a2 was greater than 0, then we said, yes, if a2 is greater than 0, the function will take its minimum and therefore it will go from both sides to infinity. Okay. If a2 is less than 0, then the function will take its maximum and from both sides it will go down and it will be unbounded. Now, from the graphs that you have seen in the earlier lectures, as well as in this lecture, it is very clear that these functions, polynomial functions, are either increasing or decreasing based on the way they wish, right? So for example, it can be like this also, so or it can go like this also, or it can be a straight line as well if it is linear, or it can move like this. So all these are polynomial functions. So now we want to have a better understanding. So what is the behavior of a function after it has passed through all the roots is the question, right? That is the term that was troubling us a lot. So for quadratic equations, we have decided that it is basically based on a2. This quadratic equation, the highest degree is 2. So a2, it is decided. So now, in a similar manner, if I want to consider a polynomial function fx, which is equal to an x raised to n, an minus plus an minus 1 x raised to n minus 1, and so on up to a0, then the behavior should be decided by this term. Why should I make this claim? Because if you look at x raised to n, what we are looking for is, as the value of x increases or as the value of x decreases. Now it is not in that zone where it is passing through many roots. So it has passed through all its possible roots, and now after that, how the function will behave? There is no determining factor. So in such case, the only determining factor is the term an x raised to n. Why? Because for large values of x, this term x raised to n will dominate all other terms corresponding to x. X raised to n will dominate x raised to n minus 1, x, and so on. That is when x is becoming large. When x is becoming small, that is x is tending to minus infinity, the term x will be the small, x raised to n will be the smallest possible term. Or if we that n is of even degree, still it will be the largest possible term. In any case, the behavior of an x raised to n will play a dominant role in identifying the behavior beyond roots of the polynomials or beyond zeros of the polynomials. This behavior we will call as end behavior of a function. And for polynomial functions, it is determined by the leading terms, that is an x raised to n. If this an is greater than 0, if this an is greater than 0 and x raised to n, that n is an even power, exponent is even, then as x increases or decreases, it is very similar to quadratic. As x increases or decreases, fx will always go to infinity. If an is less than 0, n is an even exponent, then whether x increases or decreases, fx will go to minus infinity. It will go on decreasing. Good. Then what if an x raised to n, that n is the exponent which is of odd power, or exponent is odd? What happens? If an is greater than 0, if an is greater than 0, then as the function increases, fx also increases. If an is greater than 0 and it is of odd power, as x increases, fx also increases. As x decreases, fx also decreases. And both are going to infinity. One is going to plus infinity, another one is going to minus infinity. They both are unbounded. Similar thing can be argued for an less than 0. So in order to improve our understanding, I have tabulated this in this zone. 1 minute, let me remove this part. Okay, so this is the better understanding. So now you look at the leading term, an x raised to n. So this is referring to n. N is of even degree, n is of odd degree. So if n is of even degree and an is greater than 0, x tending to infinity, x becoming larger and larger, fx will become infinity. Fx will also increase. An is greater than 0, x tending to minus infinity, that means x is becoming smaller and smaller and smaller. But because the polynomial is of even degree, it will again go to infinity. In a similar manner, if an is greater than 0 and the polynomial, the leading exponent is of odd degree, then as x tends to infinity, fx tends to infinity. You can imagine a function of the form x cube. Similarly, if an is greater than 0, x tends to minus infinity, fx will also go to minus infinity because fx will also keep decreasing. Remember, polynomials of odd degree cross over x-axis. If you link that point to this, then naturally it is very easy to visualize the behavior of the polynomials. I will demonstrate these two graphs again, once again, to reiterate the point. If an is less than 0, now an is less than 0. That means x becoming larger, fx, the term, the leading term of fx will be negative, more and more negative. So fx will tend to infinity, minus infinity. But if x is becoming smaller and smaller, the exponent is of even degree, still fx will again go to minus infinity because an is less than 0. Come back to odd degree. Here the exact replica of what we have done for odd degree when an is greater than 0 will happen. So in this case, when an was greater than 0, f extending to infinity will make bring this fx to go to infinity, but in this case it will bring it to minus infinity. And similar case is true for the other part, that is extending to minus infinity, fx will tend to infinity. Let us visualize it through graphs. Let us take this first block, even degree, an greater than 0. Imagine a function of the form x square or x raised to 4. As x tends to infinity, both of them are going up. Just remember this figure, that will clear this understanding. Let us go to odd degree with an greater than 0. As x tends to infinity, here this is going up, this is going down. Okay. Just imagine a figure of x cube for the convenience. When an is less than 0, just imagine a figure of minus x square or minus x raised to 4. Both of them should naturally go down. That is what is written here as well. In a similar manner, just consider minus x cube. So whatever was going down will go up, and whatever was going up will go down. That's what I meant when I said this. So now we have much better hold over end behavior of polynomials. Now you can look at the graph of a polynomial function, and you, by looking at the end behavior, you can say whether the polynomial, the leading term of the polynomial, is of odd degree or even degree. That is one more understanding, one more level of understanding that we have achieved through understanding this end behavior. But that is not over. We further need better understanding of the functions.